Trying to say that three times fast. Wig Wednesday. So I have another Wig Wednesday review for you all today. And this time it is by the Janet Collection, and I'm going to be reviewing their hair Georgine in the color OET1B/silver. So it's this gorgeous ombre silver color, and I just feel like a sexy old lady. No, but real talk, I am digging this wig. I actually didn't like it at first, to be very honest with y'all. I tend to stray away from like really deep silver tones, like, you know, metal tones. I don't know, it just feels like gray, and like, you know, darker grays don't ever really compliment me or like look good on me, I feel like. And but y'all, as soon as I did my makeup, I was, you know, I was feeling myself, so I do really like this wig. I do have some thoughts on it, but of course, before we get into it, if you're new to my channel, hello, hi, and welcome. My name is Anuli, and this is Thou Art Anuli. This is me. So, and you are tuning into a wig review Wednesday of the sort. Now, if you're interested in DIYs, I also do DIYs every Sunday, so check that out too. But y'all, quick heads up, might be a little crazy this month, so if you don't see a DIY this weekend, just letting you know ahead of time, but I will make it up for y'all, so stay tuned for that. But of course, if you don't mind hitting that subscribe button as well as that bell button, because you know YouTube be playing games, definitely hit that bell button so you know when I'm posting content. And also comment down below and give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and stay tuned for more. So again, this unit is by Janet Collection, and it is their style Georgine, and it's this cute short wavy bob, very curly at the sides, and then with some straight long bangs, and it's in the color OET1B-silver. And so again, it's like an ombre silver where you have dark roots and then you have like a silver, metal silver at the bottom. Now it is curly iron and heat safe up to 360 degrees, so you can definitely use it to recurl your curls, or if you want to go ahead and straighten it out, I think it will look like a straight bob as well. And it comes in other colors such as, I think, 1B1, black blue, which is this one right here, and then there's this brown ombre right here. So if you, and then, oh, and then also blonde on the back, so if you want different colors to experiment with, they do offer different selections. I know this color is a little bit in high demand, so it might be hard to find a specific color, but I will link everything down below so you know exactly where to find the wig in general, and I'll try to see if I can find this color specifically, and I'll link that down below. Now, this is not a lace front wig. It doesn't have the lace in the front, but it's okay because you have your bangs, and so it looks pretty, you know, realistic-ish, minus, you know, the color. But I feel like the silver color, I think why I didn't like it too much was because it kind of gave me too much of a sheen, which even looking now on the camera, it feels a little too shiny. So an easy solution or an easy fix to that is just to take some powder and kind of, you know, gently apply that to the hair so it takes away that kind of wiggy sheen. I have seen quite a few videos on this wig and I was like in love, which is the way, different ways you can style it. There's actually a lot of ways you can style this wig, surprisingly. You can do like you could do like a top bun or a ponytail or like pigtails. So there's a lot of different ways you can style it. Now, I personally, I'm all about the flip over because I just feel like it makes me look like a cute little witch. So the cap itself does not come with any combs whatsoever, which I was very, very surprised at, because most wigs usually come with combs, or at least like two combs maybe in the front. Now, I feel like this is a trend that people don't be putting back combs anymore in the back, because I feel like it's an important spot, but definitely some combs would be nice in this wig. It is pretty snug on my head, and I think it's big head friendly. The reason why I say I think is because it is a little tiny bit tight, but if I undo the straps, but the straps are like the ends, that's how big my head is, y'all. Don't make fun of me. So if I do kind of undo the straps a little bit, it will kind of give a little bit, but I also need to rebraid my braids under, so maybe that will help. Like I said, there's really no lace to install or glue down, so it's one of those wigs that you can just simply pop and go. So this is definitely gonna be a go-to. Now, I haven't experienced any shedding whatsoever with this wig thus far. It doesn't tangle really because it's just a short wig, so it doesn't have much to tangle in. And then the density is not too high so that it's, you know, too much hairs and fibers to be working with, but it does have a bit of volume thanks to the curls and the waves. I think that it is overall a great wig. It's really just the cap that is the most kind of, not con necessarily, but just it could be a little bit wider for people who have really large skulls like myself. So yeah, that is pretty much it for this. Again, y'all, I don't really know the price, so I will put it in the sidebar down here or in the description box down below so you can check that out. So y'all, that is all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Again, if you haven't already, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well as the like button, bell button, comment, you know what's up. And I'll see y'all soon with a new video. Bye.